Welcome to Holman United Methodist Church, located in Los Angeles, California. We are a church that believes in the Word of God as it is manifested in Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. We believe in the Holy Bible, and we trust that there is a word of hope, instruction, and healing for us all. Thanks for joining us today, and let's journey together as we follow God. Good morning, and welcome to the Holman United Methodist Church experience, where we believe God is still blessing, God is still moving, God is still delivering in our lives and in the world. It is on this day that we also celebrate the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. weekend, and we are very appreciative of his life and his legacy. Let's give the Lord a hand praise for that. So we believe that let all those who draw breath shout for joy and sing praises to our living God. I know that this is the new year of 2024, and I know that you already see God moving in your life, and we are thankful for what God has done, is doing, and will do in the life of our world and in our church and in our communities. It is as people of God, we are called to love one another. As people of God, we are called to affirm one another. As people of God, we are called to worship.
Please rise as you are able and join me in the call to worship. Speak to us, Lord, for your servants are listening.
The one who fashioned us in our mother's womb calls us this day.
Lead us, O God, as we will follow.
The one acquainted with all our ways leads us into the life.
Bless us, Spirit of wisdom and truth, and guide us home.
The one who hems us in from behind and before is a lamp to our feet.
Speak to us, Lord, for your servants are listening. Let us now join together in the opening hymn, Blessed Martin, Pastor, Prophet. This is found in the insert in your bulletin. Now join together in the opening prayer. Let us begin. Before you formed us in our mother's womb, you knew us completely. Before a word is on our lips, you perceive it. You hem us in before and behind. You call us as your own and lay your hand upon us. Such knowledge is too wonderful for us. It is so high, we cannot attain it. Even when we fail, Holy One, call us anew, that we might hear your voice and respond with expectation and joy. Here I am. Amen. We will now receive the ministry of music from our Holman Choir, Christians Be Joyful by J.S. Bach. Scripture this morning is found in the Gospel of John, chapter 1, verses 43 through 51. As you're able, please rise for the reading of the Gospel. The next day, Jesus decided to go to Galilee. He found Philip and said to him, "Follow me." Now, Philip was from Bethsaida, the city of Andrew and Peter. Philip found Nathanael and said to him, "We have found him about whom Moses in the law and also the prophets wrote, Jesus, son of Joseph from Nazareth." Nathanael said to him, "Can anything good come out of Nazareth?" Philip said to him, "Come and see." When Jesus saw Nathanael coming toward him, he said to him, "Here is truly an Israelite in whom there is no deceit." Nathanael asked him, "Where did you get to know me?" Jesus answered, "I saw you under the fig tree before Philip called you." Nathanael replied, "Rabbi, you are the Son of God. You are the King of Israel." Jesus answered, "Do you believe because I told you that I saw you under the fig tree? You will see greater things than these." And he said to him, "Very truly, I tell you, you will see heaven open and the angels of God ascending and descending upon the Son of Man." The word of God for the people of God. Please be seated. The Holman Choir will continue its ministry of music, singing John Carter's "I Have Been to the Mountain," and the narrators are Alvarine Scott and Elton Bailey. After which, the Reverend Dr. Ken Walden will preach the message for today, Do You Believe?
State and every city, we will be able to speed up that day when all of God's children, black and white, Jews and Gentiles, Protestants and Catholics, will be able to join hands and sing in the words of the spiritual, free at last, free at last. Thank God Almighty, we are free at last.
Martin Luther King, son of a Baptist preacher, grandson of a slave, marched and spoke before a global audience, a dominant voice in the quest for human rights, a champion of love and nonviolence in a troubled world, a man with a dream.
I have a dream that one day this nation will rise up and live out the true meaning of its creed. We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal. I have a dream that one day every valley shall be exalted, every hill and mountain shall be made low, and to throw the rough places and made plain, and the crooked places will be made straight, and the glory of the Lord shall be revealed.
Message of brotherhood and justice to cities, to states, to countries, and across the seas. He was a man who had been to the mountain, and he believed that the promised land of equality was little more than a heartbeat away.
I have tried to
Magazine's Man of the Year in 1963, winner of the Nobel Peace Prize, a preacher, a teacher, an historian, and a maker of history. Truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal, that they are endowed by their Creator with certain inalienable rights, that among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. Martin Luther King, the peaceful warrior, the freedom fighter for equality, the man of peace, the dreamer of dreams, the author of a legacy.
Now is the time to open the doors of opportunity for all of God's children. Now is the time to lift our nation from the quicksand of racial injustice to the solid rock of brotherhood.
April 4th, 1968. Martin Luther King became a victim of the violence he deplored. Shot down by an assassin's bullet, Martin the man left us. But hallelujah, Martin the peacemaker lives among us still, his spirit rejoicing in every victory we achieve in the name of freedom and dignity for all people everywhere.
Church say amen. Amen. I believe that on this Martin Luther King Jr. weekend, God still has a word of information and inspiration for us all. And I believe that word of information and inspiration can be found according to the Gospel of John, the first chapter. And it is in the form of a question, starting at the 50th verse, when we find Jesus asking Nathanael the following words: "Do you believe because I told you that I saw you under the fig tree, you will see greater things than these. I would like you to yell out the question, do you believe? Let us pray. Eternal God, we thank you, we need you, we love you, we trust you, and we ask you to continue to be with us, bless us, keep us, protect us. Touch our eyes so we may see more. Touch our ears so we may hear more. Touch our hearts so we may be more according to your will and according to your way. In the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit, in Jesus' name, and the people of God can feel free to say, amen.
Amen.
It is during this new year, 2024, this first month of January, our lectionary leads us to the scenes where Jesus is selecting his disciples. We find Jesus moving from town, to village, to hamlet, looking at different people and asking different people, instructing different people, follow me, you, yes, follow me, yes, you, follow me. And even in this year of 2024, I believe Jesus' power and presence is still going around the globe saying, you, follow me. And we find Jesus selecting two people, one person being Philip and the other person being Nathanael. Now, when Jesus encountered Philip, Philip immediately started following Jesus. It's interesting that Philip did not ask questions. We are not informed that Philip started asking questions. No, Philip didn't ask Jesus, you know, what would the food that they would be eating. Philip did not ask Jesus, you know, what are the benefits? What are the liabilities? How much will this require? You know, many of us, we like to ask questions before we make a decision. Before we go to a restaurant, if we get invited to go to a restaurant, many of us will say, well, what's on the menu? What do they have for dessert? You know, what kind of beverages do they order? Do they have inside sitting or tables, or do they have outside tables? Many of us, we will ask a lot of questions before we make a decision. We will be very hesitant. I wonder, do we apply that same kind of hesitancy to Jesus? When Jesus would like us to follow him in different places, in different situations, I wonder, do we apply that same kind of hesitancy before we follow Jesus during the day and during the night and during different seasons of our lives? But no, Philip was eager. Philip was so eager. Philip was so excited about following Jesus. Philip started telling other people about the power and the presence of Jesus. I wonder, in our discipleship with Jesus, I wonder, do we model that same kind of behavior as Philip did? I wonder if we share that story with our family, with our friends, with neighbors, with strangers, and share with people, you know what? Jesus has made a difference in my life. I would like you to meet Jesus. I would encourage you to spend time with Jesus. Jesus made the difference in my life. Jesus made the difference in my situation. Philip was so excited about meeting Jesus. He told one of his friends, Nathanael. He told Nathanael, hey, there is a person named Jesus from Nazareth, and I think you should meet him. Biblical historians tell us that Nazareth wasn't a place, it was not a final destination. It was a place where people generally traveled through rather than traveling to. It was a place where people did not put their foot off the gas pedal. You ever drove through towns that, you wanted to drive fast through that town? You didn't slow down. You didn't slow down and start looking out the window and or get over and park. You didn't want to drive to that town. You didn't want to drive to that city. You wanted to drive through that town. You wanted to drive through that city. That was the place Nazareth was. So when Philip told Nathanael, you need to meet a person by the name of Jesus from Nazareth, Nathanael's response immediately was, can anything good come out of Nazareth? Why are you so excited about meeting someone from Nazareth? We don't go to Nazareth to meet people. I can see if you were, say, in Jerusalem, but Nazareth, can anything good come out of Nazareth? Immediately, we find Nathanael not wanting to believe. Immediately, we find Nathanael with great hesitancy in his mind. Immediately, we find Nathanael with a lot of questions in his spirit. Immediately, we find Nathanael not wanting to believe. Not wanting to believe because of so much of what Nathanael saw coming out of Nazareth. Not wanting to believe because so much of what Nathanael experienced coming from Nazareth. Not wanting to believe because so much of what Nathanael thought about Nazareth. I would suggest to you on this day, on this Martin Luther King Jr. Sunday, is that what you believe is more important than what you see. What you believe is much more important than what you see. The Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., born in 1929. In all of his life, he saw signs that said, blacks only. All of his life, he saw signs that read, for whites only. Year after year and decade after decade, all of Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.'s life, he saw signs that said, keep out, stay out. All of his life, Dr. King saw policies and procedures, customs and traditions that did not ask but required black people to get to the back of the bus. He saw this with his own eyes. He witnessed this with his own eyes. He experienced it with his own life. But still, somewhere deep down in his heart, somewhere deep down in his soul, although he saw it, he believed something different. He believed that black people were just as important as all people. He believed that reconciliation was much more significant than discrimination. He believed that equality was much more paramount than inequality. My brothers and sisters, on this Dr. King weekend, I believe the Gospel of John is trying to tell us is that what we believe is so much more important than what we see. Nathaniel was hesitant because he saw so little coming out of Nazareth. Nathaniel was hesitant because he was not impressed about what he had experienced from Nazareth. And Jesus did not ask Nathaniel what he saw. Jesus asked Nathaniel, "Do you believe? What do you believe?" And I believe that question from our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ still applies to each and every one of us today. I believe that Jesus is asking you, "What do you believe?" I believe Jesus is asking us, "What do we believe?" As the winds of war go from one country to another country, what do we believe? As poverty is going from one nation to another nation, what do we believe? As weapons, as words are being weaponized, trying to diminish and reduce people, to not remain human, but reduce people as if their lives do not matter at all. We are challenged to ask the question, what do we believe? And I am happy to tell you on this day, what has saved me time and time and time again, it was not what I saw, but what I believed. Meaning that time and time and time again, I saw no way. But because I believed in Jesus, Jesus made a way out of no way. With my eyes, I saw no healing. But because I believed in Jesus, Jesus' healing hands and loving arms made everything much better. I've learned not to totally depend upon what I see, but trust more on what I believe. Dr. King preached at this pulpit. Dr. King preached at this pulpit on March 17, 1968, by the invitation of our first permanent pastor by the name of the Reverend Dr. L.L. White. Dr. King accepted the invitation and came to Holman United Methodist Church and preached a wonderful sermon. If you visit our website at Holman United Methodist Church website and click on our iCloud, our SoundCloud, and scroll all the way down, you will see a picture of the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. And if you click play, you will hear his words in his sermon. I listen to it sometimes. And in his opening comments, Dr. King gives a lot of thanks to our first permanent senior pastor, Reverend Dr. L.L. White. He thanks Dr. White for the words of encouragement. He thanks Dr. White for always returning his phone calls. And then Dr. King turns to the congregation of Holman United Methodist Church and starts thanking the congregation for always being there for SCLC with financial contributions, for always being there with the civil rights movement with financial contributions, and also prayerful support. After Dr. King thanks Dr. White, after Dr. King thanks the Holman United Methodist Church congregation, he starts exploring and highlighting his theme of hope. What's fascinating that on this day of March 17th, 1968, Dr. King had already been stabbed during a book signing, spent several nights in a hospital, but yet he's still believing in hope. What's fascinating that before March 17, 1968, yes, he did receive the Nobel Peace Prize, but the tides had turned in popular opinion so much, particularly when Dr. King started preaching against the Vietnam War, major publications and voices in so-called high places, particularly from the White House, started labeling Dr. King as one of the most dangerous men in America. But yet, he still had the courage, he still had the optimism to come to Holman United Methodist Church and still preach about hope. He still believed in hope. What's fascinating about 1968 is we start seeing other major black movements sweeping across the United States of America. And we start seeing police brutality. We start seeing churches being bombed, and homes being bombed as well. But yet, King still believed in the power of hope in the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I want you to know that the enemy does not want you to continue to believe. The adversary wants you to stop believing. The enemy will try to put everything as an obstacle in your path so you will stop believing. Because the enemy knows if you only go by what you see, oh, the adversary has you right where the adversary wants you. If you only go by of what you know, what you understand, oh, the enemy has you right where the enemy wants you. I realize that if I believe in God, I don't always have to understand it, but everything will be okay. If I believe in God, I don't always have to see it, but everything is going to be okay. If I believe in Jesus, I may not know how it's going to be worked out, but everything is going to be okay. It is during this Martin Luther King Jr. Sunday that we find the question that Jesus asked Nathanael. Nathanael, not what you see out of Nazareth, but what do you believe? Not what you have experienced out of Nazareth, but what do you believe? I believe Jesus is asking us not what we see on an everyday basis, but what do you believe Jesus can do? Not what you see going on in your home, but what do you believe Jesus can do? Not what you see going on in your jobs, but what do you believe Jesus can do? Not what you see in your medical records, but what do you believe Jesus can do? Not what you see in communities and on the streets and in relationships and in families, but what do you believe Jesus can do? Nathanael. Something in Nathanael woke up. I know that we had Epiphany Sunday a few weeks ago, but we are witnessing an epiphany that Nathanael had. In that instant, something clicked in Nathanael's mind, and he started believing more in Jesus. In that instance, something clicked in Nathanael's heart and soul, and he started believing more in Jesus. I hope during this season in our lives, you and I will have more and more epiphanies and start believing more in Jesus. I hope during this season in our lives, you and I will start connecting more of the dots in divine ways. Maybe not in logical ways, but in divine ways. And start believing more in Jesus. A few days ago, January the 11th, a sign was displayed. And the sign said, "The Reverend James Lawson Mall." The Reverend James Lawson Mall is between Crenshaw and Arlington, right on our West Adams Boulevard. And as I was sitting on the stage with Reverend James Lawson, he and I, we were laughing, going back and forth with one another as we usually do. And before I had to give a few words, there was a song that was sung by a singer, and the young man sung, "A Change Is Going to Come." And I started thinking about the lyrics, and I started thinking about the changes that's been taking place in our country. I started thinking about the signs that's been up in our country that Reverend Lawson saw, the signs again that said, "Keep out and stay out." Even on public hospitals, when Black people paid for the hospitals with their tax dollars, but they couldn't go through the front door. Signs that said, "Stay out and keep out." Signs at public colleges and universities that Black people paid for with their tax dollars, but still couldn't go through the front door. I started thinking about exactly what was Reverend Lawson thinking about when he saw his name on that sign that said the Reverend James Lawson Mao. Because all his life, he had seen other signs of exclusion, other signs that said, "Get away," other signs that said, "Get out." The enemy wants you to react to only what you see. And on your journey, you may see signs and you may hear signs that instruct you to keep out and stay out. You may see signs or hear signs that tell you you do not belong. You may see signs and hear signs symbolically or figuratively to ask you to go backwards rather than frontwards. But because Reverend Lawson, similar to Dr. King, did not primarily act on what he saw, but primarily acted upon what he believed. So I am glad to tell you on this Sunday, Martin Luther King Jr. Sunday, I may see a lot of hate going on, but I believe more in the power of love. During this season of our lives, we may see a lot of divisions and we may see a lot of illnesses, but we believe more in the power of God's healing. It is on this Sunday, this King Sunday, that we may see forces trying to roll back the hands of progress with trying to make it difficult for Black and brown people to vote and or become full citizens. But we believe more in the power of justice, in the power of equality, in the power of equity. Yes, we may see a lot of things, but we thank God what we believe. And we believe in the power and in the name of the Father, the Son, and in the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name, that's what we believe. And the church says, amen. It is at this time, I encourage you during this King weekend to continue to be mindful about what you see and what you believe. The enemy has become an expert in projecting false illusions that may look real to our eyes. I invite us to come to the altar to ask God to help us believe. And also, for those of you who may want to become an official member of Holman United Methodist Church, you may believe that this church is for you. I encourage you to share that information with me as well. You are welcome to the altar for prayer. Of you for your prayerful support and also your financial support. It means a lot as we have had a strong finish in 2023 and moving stronger in 2024. We thank those who join us on the radio and also on our home and YouTube channel. We thank you for your prayerful support, and we also thank you for your financial support. Let us pray. Eternal God, we thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for allowing this world to be not only what we see. We thank you, Lord, for allowing our families and our situations to be not only what we see. Lord, we thank you for gifting us with the power of belief, a belief in you that's much greater than us. So, Lord, during this January 2024, Lord, we are believing in healing. We are believing in renewal. We are believing in forgiveness. We are believing in rest. We are believing in restoration. We are believing in a way out of no way. Lord, in the name of Jesus, we are believing in your power and your presence. We want you to heal, touch, renew, restore. God, we ask you to bless, continue to bless Holman United Methodist Church. Continue to bless our members. Continue to bless our friends. Continue to bless our visitors. Continue to bless our institutional partners. Continue to bless our strangers. Continue to bless our neighbors, our homes, our jobs, our communities. Lord, we believe if you cannot do it, it cannot be done, but all things are possible by the power and the presence of your holy name. So Lord, we lift up the life and legacy of the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. And we thank you for not allowing him to move according to what he saw, but we thank you for allowing him to move according to what he believed in. So God, may our belief in equality, in equity, in justice, continue to be applied all throughout the country for all peoples, all races, all creeds, all nationalities. So Lord, whatever we have, we give unto you. We ask you to bless it, multiply it. May it be used according to your will and according to your way. In the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit, in Jesus' name, and the church can feel free to say, amen. Reverend Chase, do you have some announcements for us, sir?
Indeed. Brothers and sisters, today's altar flowers are given by Joyce Burrell Garcia in memory of her mother. She says, thank you for always loving us. Her mother, Jewel K. January, showing us his way and guiding us. We still feel your love guiding us. You are always in our hearts. We love you and miss you dearly. Forever, mother, forever. Glory to God. Amen. And this is also from Joyce, Barbara, Christopher, Gresham, and Victor. Pray for the bereaved. Longtime member William Bill Hardy transitioned January 3. Funeral services are scheduled at Holman for Saturday, January 27 at 10 a.m. There will be a celebration of the life of Holman member Jonetta Jones this Friday, January 19th at 11 a.m. in the sanctuary. The viewing for Mrs. Jones will be one day before, Thursday, January 18 at Angela's Funeral Home, located at 3875 Crenshaw Boulevard between 9 a.m. and 4 p.m. Funeral services for Kevin McGruder are scheduled Thursday, January 25th at 11 a.m. in the Holman Sanctuary. Services for Mr. Roger Johnson, begin on Wednesday, January 17th, with a viewing at Inglewood Mortuary at 1206 Centinella Avenue between 4 and 7 p.m. There will be a graveside service at Inglewood Park Cemetery, 720 East Florence Boulevard at 11 a.m. on Thursday, January 18th. Please remember these families in prayer. Prayer requests, please continue to pray for Dr. Harold Jordan, Barbara Lake, Freddie Muse Jr., and Everett Williams. And now general announcements. On Tuesday, January 9, Holman posted the last installment of its 2023 apportionment, fulfilling 100% of our obligation to the conference. We thank you, Holman family, for your generosity. In observance of Dr. King's birthday, the Holman office will be closed on Monday, January 15. We will reopen at 10 a.m. on Tuesday, January 16th. Happy birthday. I'm sure we would all want to say happy birthday to Dr. King. For several years, Holman has been part of the Greater Los Angeles Homeless Count. The count for West Adams begins on January 25th at 6:30 here at Holman. Register for this vital public service at the count, theycountwillyou.org. Listen and reply. The Sunday school lesson for children is available on the Holman website. Families are encouraged to share the lesson with their children. Please connect with us as we gather for dynamic worship, grow through inspired learning, go into joyful service, and live the gospel of Jesus Christ. We thank you for your continued partnership in ministry. God bless each one of you.
Oh, thank you. I would like to share with you all some exciting news going on at Holman, because God is still moving at Holman United Methodist Church. And the exciting news, because we believe in the significance of Black culture and Black people and Black history. In 2024, we will be introducing Saturday School of African American History. And I want you to save the date for an opening, February 17th, 2024, from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. We're going to have an orientation, a focus group for Saturday School of African American History. So February 17th, 2024, from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. More information will be in the bulletins and also our bell ringer, but we are excited about this wonderful initiative that will be happening. I want to thank the Church Council for the support with this, and also many of our church leaders. With that being said, I ask you to please stand. Please stand. Stand in God's love. Stand in God's mercy. Stand and continue to open your eyes, your ears, and your hearts and receive this blessing. May you continue to believe in the power of God. May your belief increase in the power of love. May your belief increase in the power of redemption and forgiveness and renewal. And may God's angels, may God's Holy Spirit continue to protect you and direct you all the days of your lives and beyond. In Jesus' name we pray. And the church says, Amen.
Amen.